CEO Promise Records, and this is my studio, as you can see here. Mini studio setup. Let's take a look.
Okay, before kicking starts this video, there are three key things you'll do for me. Number one, you'll be patient with this video because it's going to take a bit of time. Number two, you'll play it to the end to gain something from this video. And number three, you click the subscribe button. So I want to take time to explain certain things before we get right into the practical session of this video. So please be patient. Number one, there are certain things they are not telling you. There are some facts about recording that you don't know. To get a very good mixed job, it all starts from your recording. When I was growing up as a producer, I used to see people do these things a lot. They will record in a very noisy environment and they will tell you they are processors. Don't worry, we can process it. And it has a way of showing how good you are. It's not true. Those things are, I call them Agbero method. It is number one key thing to get a clean backing vocals mixed. Number one, that thing is record on a quiet environment, on a very quiet environment. If possible, if your place is very noisy, create a little booth for yourself. Let me show you my recording booth.
So that's my recording booth, as you can see. You can see my recording booth. This is the outside session. This is my speakers. So you can see my boot is properly locked and properly padded and no noise get in. That's one. Because if you record in a noisy environment and you are trying to raise some of the highs, because it's a backing vocals, so sometimes you like to pick the highs and the high mid and some of those parts. As you are raising them, the background noise is going with them. And somebody will say, why not use filters? Why not use denoise and the rest? The moment you start to denoise, you start to remove noise, you start to do all those stuff, there is a part of the vocals that dies with the denoise filter. So many producers, they won't tell you this. So that's one. Number two, get a very good voice texture. This is what the white guys are leveraging on. So they do everything on a clean bass. They do everything on the steady bass and everything is on a balanced ratio. We Nigerians, we prefer to work on Agbero method. We just do ja-ja-ja-ja-ja-ja and just garbage everything together. No, as a producer, do not record any kind of voice. It is your name that is at stake. I hope somebody got that. Always get a strong and a good voice texture before you record. Okay, number three is make sure the person is singing the right thing. The backup must be strong. This is why I normally do one backup vocalist. Most times, if I get a very good backup vocalist, I do one. I will do multiple takes, which is what we are going to be doing right now. Just one person. So one person will do all the takes for me and I'm good with it. I know you want to dive right into the practical session, but let me shock you, bro. Sis, there is no good mix without a good recording. Forget it. If your recording is bad, there's almost nothing that they can do for you. If you like, let them lay hands on you and pour oil on your head.
There was no granite oil. And I used my mother's anointing oil to fry the egg.
A mix will still be bad. It can't come out like a professional mix. So don't forget, number one, record on a quiet environment, as quiet as possible. Number two, understand your space. As you can see, my space is not that big and I'm recording inside a booth. After recording, then I will create my vocal space with my software. So the fourth thing or the fifth thing is understanding your space. If you're recording with a wooden kind of part, you are good to go. If you're recording in a tiles environment or whereby the walls are tile and here and there, you will need a curtain. Get curtains and place them on top of the tiles. If your floor is tiles, you will need a rug on top of it. These are some of the key little things that gives a very good mix. If your space is big, you don't need to spread or push the vocals up that much, because originally your mic is already picking the space, your surrounding, your space. Understand your space, because my booth is small, so I will need more effects to push the vocals up and to spread them a bit. You understand? But if you have a fuller space already, it depends. Okay, number five or number six is how you record. Your recording skills helps in things like this. You must develop a recording skills, especially for backup vocalists. Sometimes I just like to do some twists on the vocals. So let me show you how I mix my vocals. All right, this is Cubase 13 Pro and I have a project here. The project is titled Ogene Rukeve. It's an Urubu song. It's a native song. Kudos to the artist Desmond. Okay, so let me play the vocals without any processor.
For all you've done for me, for things you brought my way, for the joy you've given me, oh Gennado. You died that I may live. You've shown me love and grace. You gave me love and hope, oh Gennado.
Now you can hear the precision, can feel the accelerando. So let's process the voice. Now you need 16s, you need an EQ. You need an EQ to remove some odd sounds. Number two, you need a compressor. Three, you need another EQ to amplify the good sounds. Number four, you need a filter to take off those excesses like and those rumbling. And you need a gate to close up the ends where the person is not singing. Then number six, you need an effect. You need one send effect track to push up the vocals. So let us go. So the first thing you will do here is right click. If you have not done that before, go back to add group track. I've already added the group track, so I don't need to add that again. Add the group track. This is mine. I normally do 4 group tracks or 5. So you can name it BGVs or you can name it backup vocals. And you can give it any name you want to give it. That's one. After creating a group track and naming it, then you come back to your vocals. Of course, I've already done my panning. So if you miss that tutorial, please just kindly go to my page and look for how to pan up. Simply click up here. After doing your panning, then you have to direct all the vocals into that group track. How do you do that? You click the first track, come over to this session here, your output routing, click it. You see all your groups here. Look for that particular backup vocal group that you created. Click it one, go to the next, and go to the next, and route all of them like that. Once you've done, then you open your group track or simply go to your mixer. You can scroll towards the S stream and you see it right here. So I don't like stress, let me just come here. So I will come over to my group, the group track that I created, and click it so that I can process everything at once and open up the mixing panel for mixing. All right, if you check this angle, you see that we have 18 sources routed into this group track. Solo, make sure you solo it so that you can hear only the backup vocals. The first thing we're going to add is to add an EQ that will remove some odd sounds. I will recommend that you mix with a speaker to reveal all the ends, a three-way speaker. I have one here, high, mid, and low. So first thing we'll add from FabFitter is called MB. I will drop all the names of all the processors I will use on the description below so that you can pick them and use them. So the first thing I will do, I will start to play the vocals.
For all you've done for me.
I will start to locate the rumbling ends. And take notes, because I worked with all female, there was no male, so I won't have much of a rumbling end. What I'll do is I'll come to this end, click it, then solo it to here. I'll reduce the threshold a bit. It has compressor inside, so you can use it as a de-esser, a compressor, and an EQ at the same time. So I will also come over to this end and solo it. Okay.
You died and I may live. You show me love and grace.
All right. I also look for this end. So what I recommend is push it up first of all. Push to hear that particular sound. They look for that old sound in the voice. Then kill it. And note, it's a fast song, so you need to control your attack a bit. Then lastly, I'll just come to this end, those years in end, and just okay. I think at this point I've done 50%, so I will come over to this portion. I will come to this place, load strip presets, and just write vocals. Sometimes I work with Cubase presets. So this is vocal BGV female country. Let me try this one. It's a bit too strong. So what I will do, sometimes I get some presets and I just rework on them a bit.
For all you've done for me, for things you brought my way, for the joy you've given me, Ogenedo.
Then I will come to this end. If you are using Cubase 5, you might not likely have this session, this pre-session. So I'll key this part. So the next thing I'll add is a compressor by same Fab Fitter. Fab Fitter compressor.
You dad and I may leave. You show me love and ways. You gave me love and hope again and
all. Alright. So now we'll add an EQ by same Fab Fitter. So the area that I work on here is my 5 to my 10k area. Alright, I'm still hearing some odd sounds over this end.
You brought my way for the joy you've given me. Okay, you dad.
I would like to raise this session a bit so that the, because it's a female that sang the song, you understand? So that the low end of the female voice can still come up a bit. Fantastic. So now we need some filters. You can use a preset filters, and there are many kinds of filters that you can use in your effects section. I have CLA, I have many of them, but there is one I normally use. It's my favorite. It's called Fresh Hair. Fresh Hair will just do the job like magic. So all you need to do, you just raise this knob until you get to the point where you need, you feel is okay. So let's play the voices.
You show me love and ways.
Good.
You gave me love and hope.
This is my mid hair, this is my high hair.
Okay.
For all you've done for me.
You need a gate to close up some ends, especially where the voices are not singing, to avoid noise. Part where they are trying to clear their airway, tapping of the feet or movement of hands. Those sessions, your gate can just close them up. I normally use NX1. Like I said, I have a way of using my plugins. So I use NX1 stereo. You can use a normal gate from Cubase. Depends on the one that does it for you. If you look at all the plugins, I don't need to do too much work. They are inbuilt. So if I move this guy up, you find out that any background sound is dead automatically. It's called NS1 from Waves.
You dad and I may leave. You show me.
It's going to cut down any session where there is no sound.
You gave me love and hope.
So another thing I'm going to add is called the breath control. It's important that you control the breath. Okay, now to be sure that your breath control software is working, just come to this place, output breath only, click it, then you can hear only the breath. Yeah. So that's been done. Then one last thing I'm going to add is my effects to spread the vocals a bit. So I'll right click and I'll go to add effect track. I already have one, so there will be no need to create another effect track. If you have not done yours, just come over here, click add effect track. So I'll come over here and over to my send session. I have given it a name already, BGV FX effect. I'll click it, put it on and make sure it's on. Then go over to that particular effect track and start to work on it. So let's hear everything here.
That I may leave. You show me love and grace.
Sometimes what I normally do, I will increase the volume of that effect plugin so that I can hear all the ends properly before I will start to control it back. Okay, there are some ends that I do not really like. So I will locate that particular sound that is making the voices to sound very odd.
All you've done for me, for this you broke my heart.
So I'll take down this guy. Alright, having done that, I will now regulate the mix.
You can and I make it. You show me love and grace. You gave me love and hope again and
Alright.
For all you've done for me, for things you brought my way. For the joy you've given me, again and oh. You died and I made it. You showed me love and grace. You gave me love and hope, again and oh.
Okay, having done that, the last thing I'll do before I stop, I will add a spread plugin. We call it spread, or you can also work with similar plugins. So let me spread up this vocals. So this is called BS Shared Spread. It is used to spread the vocals to the extreme a bit.
For all you've done for me,
you can see.
For things you brought my way. For see. The joy you've given me.
Look at it now. This is mono. This is stereo. Okay. I think I am good to go. Of course, this tutorial cannot carry everything. So there are some little touch you still need to do later on, like checking if the voices are well balanced. Is any voice overpowering any voice? When you are done mixing with your speakers, unplug it from your speaker, let it not sound from your laptop speaker if you have one. It is very needful that you hear it from your laptop speaker. Here's the reason, because people will later play that same song on phones. Some will play it on phones, some play it on earpiece, some play it on... So what you can simply do, just use your laptop speaker as a balancing guide for all phone devices. You understand? One more thing before I go. Come over to your compressor. Go to your sidechain. Look at it here. Activate sidechain. Click it. Come over to this session. Click it. Then can sidechain it. It's because I'm not balancing yet. So I would love to sidechain it over the instrumental. So you look for a particular plugin that is dominant, a particular session that is dominant in the song, and sidechain it to that particular instrument in the song, so that no matter how loud that instrument goes, the vocals will still be suppressing it. The vocals will still be on top. That's the work of a sidechain. You can do that with EQ, you can do that with compressor. If I go to my EQ here now, I can still sidechain my EQ also. But I won't do that now because it is just a tutorial. So God bless you. Thank you very much for listening. Please, if you have questions, if you have contribution, if you know some of these plugins that we don't know, please put it in the comment section. If you know some of these substitute plugins for what I just used, you can place it on the comment section so that other people can learn from there. Also, feel free to ask questions. You can also demand the links to some of these plugins. I will put it on the comment section if it is needful. Thank you for listening. My name is Promise Bay. Once more, see you around. God bless you.